start first with apology. Make una forgive us. He got the way when we say technology, they do. But based on say we get sense, we dey on top of the situation. And now they say, good evening and welcome to that Ogbonge Politics Discussion Show. As in the heart, based on say we don't already chop 5 minutes inside our time. No need to talk too much. My name na Ezugo Chukwude. And as usual, I know they know this side studio. I there with my brother. When Sabi well, I stay concerned the politics matter. Unkubi. I don't talk your name. Which one be this thing? But we just go straight. We say 5 minutes don't go. You won't already they talk. You see, so I rush everything.
I don't like infringing on my own.
Our first story get to do with something very, very, very important. Generator. Hey! Waiting generator go cause inside this our great country Nigeria. Now something when we say you go put people inside serious tension. Oh, gist don't come out say 1.6 trillion naira. What is me 3 trillion? I go break it down. For those when we say they sabi mathematics, we get 100 tens and units. If we come from the smallest, you can't get 1,000, 10,000, 100,000. You can't get million, 10 million, 100 million. You can get billion, 10 billion, 100 billion. You can get 3 trillion. That one, a trillion, I be say, now be the forefather.
Is 100 billion into 10.
100 billion into 10. The father of billion. Now in Nigeria, they spend, say, with the carry generator. Enter inside this country every year.
Hey!
Every year.
Hey, annually.
No, if I shout up again now, because I said I shout to come here, shout. Every year. Now, what would they spend? Annually, now, every year. Make we ask ourselves this simple question. When we reach the level where we say, if I say hope no day again, we not fit creatively think. Make we feel do say our power sector makes sense after all the money we would not invest on top. See the kind of money we would spend, say with the carry generator come inside this country. Nigerians, I don't go talk for English, I'll talk for Yoruba. Ejo Eronu.
Hey. Well, the final gist we'll get for now got to do with one particular issue. We say it is stir up actions from different people, and which of course one of the people where they now the biggest opposition party, which is PDP, and a couple of other people. As the gist way don't go around, talk say federal government withdraw over $1.6 billion from the excess crude account in 2 weeks. In 2 weeks, and these 2 weeks play out between November 25 to December 19. And according to the waiting, the permanent secretary to the Ministry of Finance, that's Oga Mahmood Issa Dutsi, he come and talk, say, look, say, the reason why this thing happened, at least to inject them into some kind of sectors will go actually fit them, at least them help our nation and all that. And then we got to be recall. We got to be recall, say, by this time last year, at approximately for December last year, nine governors gathered. If I'm not wrong, means okay, so they go withdraw $1 billion. $1 billion to do it, to channel them, to buy arms and do every other security matter, so that at least the issue of Boko Haram was on the here, so at least they go completely wipe them off. And that the back of story we follow up say when the authorities, when the spokesperson for the army come and come talk related to that particular $1 billion they talk, he come talk say look, say that particular $1 billion they talk say they won't give. Say at least the process never reach their own hand. Or to say the money never reach their own hand. Hey, well, Chukudi, I cannot talk further than this.
When I don't hear the first stories when we say we carry call. Nigerians, when they talk up, say everything will concern this country, he need to prepare us for body. If he prepare us for body, now he say, well, they take matter will concern Nigeria very seriously. Make we rush, go this break. When we go this break, come back, we will try our phone lines open.
Yes.
I don't hear the first stories we will carry come. We not go talk in our mind as they concern this matter. And remember, on top of our city heart, you get the right to talk your mind, but we not they allow for insult. We not they allow for the one we go cause confusion. You go talk your mind. Let we go come back. We'll continue the discussion based on acid heart. Welcome back to acid heart. Here's good chukuli and look inside studio. And we get a bonga visitor when we say, you know they work anyhow. From the title, when we saying the answer, if you hear for Yoruba land, if they come and say, Aremo, it means say the person they very, very important. So when he come out, you go, no, say the talk, when he go talk, now talk when we say, he must touch you for your heart. Now we're going fast forward to the 21st century. If Aremo, they discuss matter when concern everybody inside the society, when in the, you go, no, say, now serious matter, when get to do it, what they call Oshelu or Awon Odo, in the based on the understanding of Omoluabi. All this is what I talk. If you don't understand Yoruba, you're not going to really get that. But based on saying that people would speak, when we start the question and answer, you go know why I talk so. And I be the person when we say you wear the jersey of the Alliance for Democracy, AD, the political party inside this our great country, Nigeria, one of the 91. And for the federal reps arrangement, that is those when we say they'll go represent their people for the center based on a TIOSA arrangement. And they talk of no other than Aremo, I must put the title, barrister, because he read law book, and you know, say, he got to say, if you talk to lawyer, anyhow, if you cause quarrel, so make a give him the respect, Aremo, barrister, Hassan Oladotun, welcome to Acid Hot.
Yeah, they are very happy. Good evening, my people.
Now you get this handshake.
Yes, you're welcome, barrister. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Muku no waste time, Muku just go straight into the matter. We don't bring four action to the, we go like more first discuss that one before we go enter what you get to do for your people when they inside the ATOSA. Now we talk one, we get to do it, money inside this our great country. And what Nigerians they spend to import and service generator for this country. And according to the joy body, when we say Nadia Woko, based on say that they follow them, they look say, okay, we know these things. Now then they give this information. They don't come out to talk, say, according to the recent statistics, say every year, Nigerians, they spend 1.6 trillion naira. And we break them down, and maybe people understand, say, trillion. Now, the 4444444444 father of billion is senior billion. And Nigerians, they spend every year to import and also maintain their generator. And the people who talk this one are the National Environmental Standards and Regulations Enforcement Agency. Now, John, but we're supposed to know this thing. So, nobody said, I mean, they talk out. Make I ask you, since we returned to democratic rule for 1999, I know of one particular government where people talk say they spent $16 billion for power. Yeah. And yet we see this level for 2018, where agency, they come out, they tell us, say, we they spend 1.6 trillion every year on power. Make I ask you, Shena say all power belongs to God. And are there our solution day, or the problem of Nigeria today concern say light today, not spiritual problem.
Well, our situation get K-leg from beginning. And when the talk say if the foundation they destroy, waiting you won't come they do again, waiting righteous go do. Now this Nigerian situation be that. Because the power problem is like some people just believe, say, we must remain a dark nation. It is not unfortunate that some black countries are more far ahead of us. Even Benin Republic, there, their power no they go at all. It's quite the giant of Africa, who they call ourselves, is like a giant with a clay feet, where we say we still day backward. And this issue of power, this 1.  something trillion, where you talk, is an understatement. Most of our daily living, an average Nigerian spend no less than 1,000 naira on generator every night to sleep. An average Nigeria, for those that are using generator every, because you, no matter what, you must budget for it daily, because it will get to you to the middle of the night. You want to say, this light don't go. You are never not sure. So that has become part of our daily living. That expenses on generator is more or less part of our, just as they heat every day. Now, so
normal regular thing.
So generator, now just like normal regular. So that 1.something trillion is like an understatement. Because this is the only avenue that collects most, every an average Nigerian spend money to service in this nation. And nobody say our government no they are aware of this our problem. Successive government from military to civilian, now to the present level where we still day, which is still civilian, we still be like say we still day under what they talk, they don't chain us. And if we cannot at this 21st century plan as a nation, where we say we still put power on exclusive list. One of our problems, if you don't know, you need to go to the root of the problem. It's not the generator that we are buying or the generator seller that is our problem, or the cabal behind the generator selling, or those that want to sell fuel for more consumption of the people. But the real major problem is the law that is regulating the country. If the present way we are now running our power problem, which is a fundamental problem, is even one of my basic, one of my fundamental interests that I'm going into the House for, which I've already been able to devise a solution, which I call National Electricity Right and Consumer Protection and Electricity Right Bill. Nigerians today, even on the amount you are spending on power monthly, plus the amount you spend on generator, the amount you spend on power is mostly of equal amount of the same
with
amount
the because you are spending generator,
estimated bill. It's like, say, the NEPA people, then they calculate per night how much you they spend on generator, can't give you for months. Now, so NEPA they do now. Estimated bills. And that on its own, compared to the generator, compared to the, it's like Nigerians are just being punished for waiting they don't know. So one of my basic rights is to ensure, and my duty is to make sure that within the first 100 days, if elected under the Alliance for Democracy, I'm not just representing a choice alone. My large constituency is Nigeria, if I'm at that chamber. So what thing I won't go do be say, this power problem, make we firstly review our constitution. Make we firstly see, you know, one of the duty of this restructuring are for us to get constitution, we go come out this exclusively, it's come bring and call local government, not even state. If we bring power to local government level, commercialize power to local government level, ensure that for every area, there are, you know, various means whereby it can generate power energy. And power energy can be generated through solar, through coal, through gas,
hydro.
So through hydro. Let everybody, let every local government, let power generation goes to the local government and let there be partnership. In Lagos alone, if power is decentralized in Lagos alone, ordinary private companies that we have in Lagos will generate power for us, and it will even cover the whole of Lagos. And we'll be giving power 24/7. There are some areas in Lagos that power don't even blink at all because there is a plan. So, but the wickedness of our leaders is part of our problem as a people. And because we as a people too, we are not asking the right question. Somebody will say, I will give you 4,000 megawatts in 21st century. I'll give you 10,000 megawatts in 21st century. Those promises are like taking us back to colonial days. So if you cannot bring proper solution as a government, call for a power summit, review the laws, ensure that those that are private are coming into the privatization of power are people that are competent, not politicians, not people who just want to acquire all the gencos and the discos for their own personal pocket, but people who has the experience, corporate multinationals, whose sole duty is power generation and power projection and to servicing the populace. So if we have all this technicality problem being solved, Nigeria is capable of generating 100,000 megawatts because we have over 70 local government and LCDAs in some other areas. If every local government is generating a 1,000 megawatts within their own area, and the state governments too are generating their own megawatts as a state, the federal government don't, whatever they generate is just a complementary to whatever we will have at the end of the day. So on that level, I think we need to be thinking about solutions.
Okay, talking about and thinking about solution, then the chairman of the APC, that's Adams Oshimole, he come out, he can't talk one thing. And when he talk this thing, I know say a lot of Nigerians will say, they will first shock. I want to be this thing talk. He talk, say, look, say the reason why Nigerians never see the good work of Oga Perez do, so perhaps the reason why they never see the good work of the president in the last 3 years, now because of, say, the rot we don't do in the system. Don't they too much? And referring it back to 16 years of PDP leadership. But we don't see this back and forth complaints about past government. Of course, we know also take away the fact, say, a lot of the people where they complain about past government, they for this present government. But make we even put aside our, make we come look at the reality, look what you talk. What you talk now? China, an indirect acceptance, say, okay, say we never really feel do our work the way we supposed to do. Or perhaps, say, they don't do one, but they never feel see the result. Mm. Nigerians never see the result.
The problem, you know, as I take na K-leg. Mm. If something get K-leg from down, if they look for solution from the head, Buhari alone as our president is not the problem of Nigeria.
Mm. Mm.
Just like if you go carry Jesus Christ, may he come run Nigeria. Just give him 10 days. 10 days, so leave Jesus Christ as saint as he is. With the kind of system and the kind of cultural background we have for this country, we will run the country aground like the way we have, because we are not prepared. That is why our problem is for us to go root into the root of our challenge. If you begin to look at President Muhammadu Buhari today, if another president comes there tomorrow after his own tenure, maybe even if he's been re-elected, and we are still having, you know, Nigeria power problem, no be 4 years interval where person could talk, say, I want to run a dash, and I'll get it and give it to you within 4 years. No, you must be able to have institutional planning, structures. If you are coming for 16 years of PDP rot, within the 3.5 years now that we have been, had there not been rots in some areas of this country, we are seeing it every day. Rot is part of like our endemic for this country. So the thing where they call corruption, that one, be like say na Siamese. We need to treat it as a cultural issues that must be given adequate attention. It is not a government that will promise that I will kill corruption. No government can say I will kill corruption. But you must have plans that will deliberately shut down corruption intentions. As a lawyer, the major thing will make you commit crime. Now, within day your mind, they call menstruals. If your menstruals don't calculate, say this thing I won't go do them. You don't they think about it to convert 1,000 to 1 million and convert to 1 billion and thief. And at the end of the day, you can't carry by Rukongo actam, nine be actors reals. Those two things, if you don't day your memory and you don't go actam, you don't commit corruption. But what thing will make you do not commit that thing? Now, when we say you've seen the fact that there is no need for you to commit corruption, that the government is already full in control to deliver its promises to the people. The people themselves are very aware of their rights. If you be people and you don't know your rights, all you just they ask for are bread and sandin, or they ask for Ankara, or they ask for Ashwebi, you are not even prepared for your rights. The kind of things that we should be prepared for now a real government. And that's one of my advantageously, as far as I'm running for this position. President, you know I'm the president of Yoruba Council of Youth. And I've been studying our problems. I've been part of discussions with elders of Yoruba, even nationally, to discuss our challenge. Looking at Awolowo's programmings and interests for his own era then, they were committed to servicing the people. So me too, I looked at it that if I ran for House of Reps, we have restructuring problem. How do I bring out solution? Okay. I've been able to formulate what is called National Restructuring Affairs Commission.
Okay.
We will now have, in addition to that National Restructuring Affairs Commission bill, we also have a bill that will now promote National Plebiscite and Referendum Commission, because INEC cannot conduct a yes or no. What it will make democracy functional is when the people are always engaged with you every day. The people have input. The people can easily say, okay, we'll call for a referendum. What it make the UK and all those things, the country, they look for Brexit, because the people are part of government. But for here, the day where you enter power, now the last day where they come on, now you go remember, say you go still go back, go source for votes. So if the people have referendum rights, there will be need for us to now call back our constitution. The present constitution, as a lawyer, I find it very disheartening that we are operating a decree under the guise of a constitution. And if the National Assembly, as at 8th National Assembly, cannot see anything wrong by giving us a new people's constitution, we need to begin to devise a method and approach to achieving that.
Make I ask you, because at least you don't bring in referendum, at least ensuring, say, we look back, look into the way we live our lives, and at least then try reorganize and so that everybody could be involved. You don't also mention one of that way, very important. You mentioned the fact that, look, say, the system don't they rot into the point where we say, at least then, it could be somehow hard. To also come out and from people, okay. You as an individual who won't contest, where they try contest for this position, Itiosa, how you in the midst of 300, because referendum or no referendum, information or no information, then they all bring them in different towns. But yet, each time they present and come for house, you go already see people, they kick them off.
Yes.
You as an individual, what did they give you that strong liver?
You know,
Shane Abezo said you be one man mopo.
No.
You
know,
one man.
You know, if you don't be involved in struggles, from my university days, I was a Nance Lagos as a chairman, student union leader. From the present society in Echosa, I don't be impactful. I'll be the convener of Anti-Lekki toll gate protest of this 1st of February where they increased toll gate. And a lot of protests at the demolition of the Kotak people. I was there to also serve the people's interest. And each time I stand for the people are always advancing progressively than when we keep quiet.
Mm-hmm.
This kind of attitude when I don't build on myself that I'm a people speaker, I'm going there to represent the will of the people. And this kind of interest, because for me, one of my policy plans is to be hosting town hall meetings, maybe bi-monthly, and we'll be having a stakeholders meeting also. Those two meetings are to bring a report of my activities.
Hmm.
If I can, you know, Echosa today is like a small Nigeria. For those that are conversant with Echosa from Obalende, Ikoyi, Lekki, Aja to Shangotedo to Majek Second Gate is a very large expanse area that houses almost all the major corporate multinational major people. But how much of this impact has transmitted to the people? The representation, and there's not much nucleus. These are things I want to breed.
Hmm.
If I get to the house, there are procedures of lawmaking. There is a committee stage, there is a first reading, second reading. There are different stages that you must be able to pass. So there is public hearing. So there are attempt for us to look at the possibility of shutting down any bill at the night assembly will be very, very minimal, because almost everybody is looking at restructuring as our birthright now.
Mm.
So all this policy plan we are bringing on board is the ingredient that will bring, because no executive can promise restructuring and give it to you without the National Assembly.
Yes,
the National Assembly, I am going there to make sure that, yes, I carry everybody along. You sit with the speaker, you engage. If eventually I'm elected the speaker, I can have my way to become a speaker of the house.
Mm.
So if eventually I have other opportunities to be at the house, to re-engage the fellow members, that this is this way that this country, let us be patriotic.
Mm-hmm.
Let's not be too discussing our constituency allowance or wardrobe allowance and all these things that makes Nigerians look the House members as people that are not on the same page with them.
Mm.
All this kind of thing, we will come together. You know, for me, when we say, I don't get involved in this type of struggle, so many struggles in my lifetime that are committed to humanity and solving people's problems. If I get to the House, bringing bills, I've already written over 20 bills that I'm taking on. These bills, if I begin
to... And you never even went out.
No, yes.
But don't they plan with you right on what you want to do?
I don't plan. I'm saying these 20 bills, at the moment, one of them is educational right bill. I mentioned it the last time I came here. Education is rotting because people, the government never see reason. Say, may they go bring that United Nations law. We legalize 26%. Education right allocation on budget. All we need to do is to domesticate that law. The way we take domesticate child right law in Nigeria, we'll domesticate that educational right law, whereby 26% allocation will become your right. No be saying that government policy go to say 8%, I won't give you this year, next year I will give you 5%. Next year
I'll come 7%.
7%. Okay. They don't even give us 3.
And I must see what we go do now. I never sure say it's just a people go look say when I don't carry our honorable come now. Although in talk I'm saying he come from Echosa, say, but also him be also a constituency for Lukam and Nigeria. I know say Echosa people that go down the jealous small. And he don't answer plenty questions we concern Nigeria. I'm gonna bring them home now to Echosa. Now you've been mentioned education. Those of us who don't live around this place, not be saying we get house here. We don't notice say plenty children they come from. If then they go school, then they come from one far angle.
Mm.
And we see this express. Some of them, their school, they decide where they go come. They get one place where they say for that the end of Bishop Aboyedekole. Now we get four schools inside there. If you go front, we get another two.
Yeah,
and these children, and they walk out from very long places. Sometimes we go see them by the side of the express. Some go to beg, say, maybe I'll teach them whenever they enter. Hmm. It can't be like, say, when we talk about Ethiopia, and the first thing they come to mind now, oh, the capital of business in Lagos. Money, 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 money. Make we look education.
Hmm.
You know, I don't say you not be executive, not be you go build school, but what thing you go fit do until law to you see say
you know,
children for years, then they're close to school and then they're near the house.
You know, my kind of plan, I know one can't do cosmetic projects. Can't they give if I enter, can't they give grinding machine and okada and all this marwa? I don't go do them.
So they would they give
my not be my empowerment, not be my empowerment be that. My empowerment be say, I don't sit down and look at the situation. Now, because say, somebody never sit down to ensure that we you know, say, when they live for Canaan land, and you come there for another side of the land, come be farming land at the same time.
Mm.
And so we be for this area. As we take good, as God take bless us rich, we will day in the midst of plenty, and we the hungry. It be like, say, somebody never think out of the box.
Mm.
And I don't come with a solution. Nationally, I'm bringing a bill called National Community Development Right Bill.
Mm.
That National Community Development Right Bill is to reverse a whole lot of, you know, we get this Federal Allocation and Fiscal Commission, where we say all the money with federal government they share them from to state and to give all local government monthly. But how much will we say the state they generate, don't they share with local government? You don't hear them before.
Mm.
That is the problem.
Mm.
We'll make sure that the money that are generated in every local government, the amount of tax they generate, the amount of income they generate, all these things, there must be a derivation that goes to local government. By right, if it is 30% by derivation, I know what that 30% will calculate if I've been able to empower the local government as an institution of government to attend to their own basic problems.
No, but so this is where you're talking about. I realize, hey, you won't draw a line between you and the governors.
No.
Because governors, we know, say, many of our local government, they all
exactly.
Be like, say.
Wait, now because, say, I don't tell you what my major problem. I won't, you know, I did talk about restructuring. They think, say, all my major problem, because we never still think calm. The day we start empowering the local government, that is the day most of our problem is half solved, because that's the government way they close to you. Whoever way you want to elect, it will be like, say, now survival of the fittest, because you must be able to elect those that will love you.
Mm-hmm.
So if I'm coming up with a bill that brings about derivation right to local government, I will not hard it up to answer your question. For me, I have devised what is called the Ethiopia Development Endowment Trust Fund.
Mm.
I know, say, if I enter, my salary cannot buy school buses for every school. If you go to Kuramo, you go to Ilasan, you go to Badore school, you go to Methodist Boys, you go to all the schools around here, even to Shongotedo, even all around us, the school pupils in those schools are more or less like they are just making them to pass through a system that is not passing through them.
Hmm.
Education is not passing through the present generation of pupils. They are just the one passing through education, because if you look at the amount of what is injected into them, yeah, most of them, except for those that went to Montessori school, all these big man school around there. For those ones where they go to all these schools where we talk about, there's no much technical solving problem. One, every school must have a school bus. Every school must have a library. Every school must have some provisional amenities that will take care of its own people.
Every school supposed to get a lab now.
So every school must be able to meet up a minimal standard. And that's what I'm talking about, 20% education allocation. I know, say, that one, it will firstly drain the federal government. They will not say we are prepared for a war to answer some fundamental problems. If we can educate our people who outsmart China in the space of 10 years, leave Nigerians who are very hardworking.
True.
Just give us opportunities for us to enable us achieve.
Yeah.
We'll do greater exploits. But because, say, some people just feel like, say, these people, we'll see cage them, we'll never free them. For how long? For me, I'm coming here to provide this HOSA endowment trust fund, whereby monthly, on a monthly basis, I will speak with the corporate multinationals here. They have what is called corporate social responsibility.
Hmm.
I don't need more than 5 companies to solve all these problems you are talking here.
Hmm.
All they need to do, adopt a school, adopt a community, adopt a street,
mm-hmm.
build it, make sure that that community is filling your impulse. It's part of your corporate social responsibility. When you are calculating your tax income, they can even give you tax holidays and tax rebate because of your impact in that community. So if I'm sitting as the House Rep member I've already started to engage my people from now that if I get there, you and I are a member of the constituency. So it's not my personal problem. But I want to institutionalize. I'm not going to name it Oladotun Azan Empowerment Scheme. No.
Come put your picture
on it. No, this one. This one, Itosa Endowment Scheme, whereby those halves, we have the halves, yeah, the people that are living in Lekki, they can donate in millions, in billions to the have-nots. All I need to do is to create that stable, put people that has prudence to manage people's interests. Mm-hmm. Engage, I've devised a method. We have 10 wards in Itosa. I'm not going to have a central constituency office. No. Yes, I'll have one as a central constituency, then I'll have annex offices in all those wards so that every ward have their own specific problem. So, ward representation officer will be there to attend to their own needs. We have what is called last record today. All I need to do for those that are beneficiaries of whatever scheme, because I was discussing with one of my, someone who's to help my constituency now because we came into the studio. We are just discussing is to empower people on information technology and marketing. And I told him, come, I want you to be training, train the trainer initiative, whereby you will be there. I only need to engage you as a trainer. Then my trainees will come to you. All I will have to do is to be paying you from the scheme, because for monthly, by monthly, I know that within a month, we would have generated a lot of funds for that project. You know, funds that will go into training different youth, different engaging different market women, empowering them in so many areas. Whereby, you know, loans today now, we have what is called all these low-income earners borrowing that microfinance that's going around. Mm-hmm. If you look at how much people are suffering in this, all the densely populated area in the hands of all these schemes that we are talking about, they, you know, most of them are locked in toilets. Most of them cannot even afford to repay those loans. The interest rate on those loans is not even properly regulated. Mm. So why do you have to kill the people? Because there is no alternative. So what have the people of Itosa should expect? Is that if these schemes comes on board, it's very easy for me to identify you that you are from my constituency with your last record. Mm-hmm. The only thing that empower you to access that is for you to show forth your last record, mm-hmm. get the scheme form. You engage areas of your interest. People will assess you. Then they will offer you. If it is grant loan, it's a no interest loan. We give you 6 months moratorium for you to firstly use the money to promote your business. Mm-hmm. Then after 6 months, you return so that other people can gain. Mm-hmm. So it's the money that will be a recycling. Mm-hmm. So that even if I leave the office, mm-hmm. it will be there. People would have learned it. You know, just like the way the Alaba people, maybe if they are training their boys now, they will train them after they are graduate. They will even empower them so that they can train other people. So that policy plan is one key thing that we focus on.
Okay, make I ask you this question. I mean, a lot of Itosa people when they watch now go talk to yes, every tweet they talk now, a very good idea. Say at least it will benefit them in the end if you eventually win and then, you know, can step into power. But and that will not go also take away the fact, say, if you come into, we know so we get representative, but if you also come into every state, we get number one citizen, which of course is the governor. And we'd also see some kind level of issues where they happen sometimes with, you know, political issues, especially if involve two political parties, where mm-hmm. you say, then they come from different districts, say, this one go one mission, say, the services of this person for this particular constituency, you know, work. How you as an individual go, so, okay, they cannot get issue with anybody, where they make a establish that relationship. So at least in go they see, say, the essence of my position there, now to make sure say, I benefit, at least I put out that way go benefit my people. And so at the end, make no judgment, what kind of relationship will fit establish with the executive arm of government for the state? So at in the end, if they carry out this constituency issue, at least they go also understand, say, yes, indeed, okay, we don't see what they do. We know we won't get issue with you.
You know, democracy is all about engagement. Waiting, we believe, say, as a person where they represent the people, you must be very, you must have a listening ear, and you must also have a heart of service.
But wait, no, match chip in. Listening ear, no, say, get some people say, Baba Sokwe, now we. If know, never come past that before
you,
us.
You know, say, you know, say, Nigeria, say, we, you know, I've told you that I've surmounted a lot of challenges. You know, presently, I'm the chairman of the NBA Lekki Forum. Okay. And I'm the stand secretary to Nigerian Bar Association, Ekpe branch of the Nigerian of lawyers. And you know, all these positions where I done they hold in the past until date, I've added a lot of value on human relations. If you lack human relations, how I can relate with my governor? At the same time, it will be answering to my calls because I will always, not by dancing like Roy Robertson, because you know me, I'm representing the constituency at the federal level to ensure that bringing the federal government and the state attention to my constituency. So the way I will relate robustly with the whoever that is the governor, the same way I will always also engage whoever that is the president, irrespective of the fact that the House must have their resolution and their means, you must be able to carve a model that they, even when they see that the way this person is going, why not let us adopt his policy plan? Why not let us see this as a national plan? Why not let us begin? Because all these things I'm talking about, we bring governance closer to the people, not government, person in government, but governance. If governance is closer, that is my priority. Whoever that is there, we will argue it, we will sort it out, we even smile over it. And to, but my number one priority is the solution. If the solution is key, irrespective of Baba Sokpe, irrespective of Iya Sokpe, we the people must also be Sokpeing. If we the people are Sokpeing and telling them that this is what we want to Sokpe, the Baba and the Iya Sokpe will also listen to us. Because waiting you they tell them, say you need, now you're right. Now their responsibility to provide. Because now the purpose of the going into politics is to represent your interests. So those areas will be a thing that I will be very available to manage as a representative.
Now, what do we go do now and I say, make we just allow you look your people when they tell us a federal constituency for eye and tell them why you representing your political party, the Alliance for Democracy, and are the most important person and the right person to do the job.
Yes, my people are listening to me that I'm your person, Barrister Oladotun Hassan. I'm calling on you to vote for me on the 16th of February, 2019. I'm running under the party Alliance for Democracy, the party with the star logo, with red and white and green, so that you'll be able to identify the party logo. Vote for me. Your vote will definitely count. If your what to make your vote count is the responsibility that I'm ready to serve you. I'm prepared to serve you. I have the passion. I have the keen interest to provide your answers to, for you. And anytime, my doors, I have a very 100% open door policy plan. And whatever that it is, we will all jointly develop the ethos of our dream.
Ethos of people now don't hear waiting. The candidate of the Alliance for Democracy for the 2019 election as they concern the Federal House of Representatives get to talk about his plans for that federal constituency. Everybody waiting for us, will they tell us, say, it don't reach the level where we were supposed they think. If we check our society, we can't check the smallest unit. That's if we build society like block. Now family, that be the smallest. If we can't check political arrangement inside our society, when they talk, say, we get ward. From there, you get constituency. From there, you get different things. When we say, if you arrange them together, if they make the society make sense. Maybe we begin to participate for the process, they ask the right questions, and if we participate, people no go longer they take us for granted. Until we come back again next week with action to read when we say the common smoke inside Nigeria political arrangements. Now you get this handshake.
Now bye-bye.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you very
much. To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.